Life itself is already a complicated thing and becomes even more so when you have to bow to people who make things harder rather than ease things for you. When you've called someone's attention to the troubling behavior and they refuse to change, downsizing that relationship is your healthiest move. And there is no need to feel guilty about moving away. After all, some links last only a season in your life. In this video, I will be showing you 5 types of people you don't need in your life. 1. Manipulators. Manipulative friends know how to get information from you to get to know your weaknesses and use them in their favor. They don't have any issue with abusing your conscience or your generosity. They are smooth talkers who always know how to convince people to buy whatever rubbish they're selling. Manipulators will talk to you as a friend and ask like they genuinely care about you. Although they do not know what makes you happy and who you are, they always know it because they want something more from you or have a hidden agenda, not because they genuinely care about you. Using the facade of friendship, these people carefully scheme against you and go away the moment they get what they want. Manipulating people can be hard to spot and even harder to deal with because they have a knack for making you feel like you are the problem. Having a manipulative person around you is toxic for your mental health. It is damaging to every part of your life. In the words of Anne Brown, author of The Backbone Power, The Science of Saying No, manipulative people do not understand the concept of boundaries. They are relentless in their pursuit of what they want and they have no regard for who gets hurt along the way. Friendship with a manipulative person is not needed, so it is best to cut it off. 2. The dishonest. Dishonest individuals never run out of a lie. They will lie to you and use another lie to cover the previous lie they told. Not only do they lie about themselves, but they will lie to you and tell you what you want to hear instead of the truth. They don't have your best interest at heart and you'll never get honest feedback from them. According to Adrienne Rich, a lie can be told with words or with silence. Dishonest people lie through their response and non-response. Some people who say they are your friends have no problem gossiping and sharing your private information. When you realize that you have friends like this, you may feel angry or feel like ending the friendship. The trouble with dishonest people is that they can hurt you in many ways. Furthermore, they can damage your other friendships by lying or spreading rumors. The best way to avoid dishonest people is to share less information with them and to not ask for their opinions on things. Stay as far as you can from these sets of individuals because you don't need them. Although the funny post on Twitter says dishonest people are the only ones you can trust because they will always be dishonest, you don't need them in your life. 3. The naysayers. The naysayers are always so quick to dump on your dreams and doubt everything and everybody. Their minds and opinions are still based on why something will not work instead of how to make it work. When you refuse to listen to their negativity and go ahead with your goals, they are always on a watch for you to fail so that they can say, "I told you, it won't work." They are the ones who will not be happy if you make it and will make fun of you if you don't. Naysayers are one set of people that successful people have stayed away from. Because according to Goodreads author Constance Chucks Friday, naysayers may become success slayers if you let what they say stay in your mind. There is nothing wrong about being honest and saying what you think. The problem starts when a person takes up an inappropriate portion of their time and energy in criticizing you without taking any action to remedy their complaints. When criticism is not constructive in any way, it has become negativism and you should ignore it. If you don't want to lose that friendship, explain to the person that their negative words don't help you. If that doesn't work, the best thing to do may be to put some space between you and the person. 4. The hostile. Hostile individuals are those set who like to stir up controversy and cause fights not only with other people but also between each other. They think everyone is out to get them, so they are always on the defensive side and their suspicious attitude makes it hard for them to love others. Hostile people are always picking on people and pointing out their flaws, and their intimidating manner pushes people away. Hostile people will never bring positivity into your life. Instead, they are full of drama. One of the reasons why these kinds of people are not suitable to have in your life is that they are incapable of understanding your problems. In reality, they are not able to neither understand nor show support for anyone around them. These people often have personality issues or narcissistic tendencies. you will realize that they are unable to put themselves in the shoes of others, an essential ability for ethical behavior. Dealing with hostile people requires both tact and strength. Although you don't need them in your life, they need you, and you can try to help them. American author Brown Brain, endearing greatly, suggests that you look at a narcissistic or hostile individual through a lens of vulnerability. There you will see the reason for their attitude is because they feel never enough. Nevertheless, if their vibes begin to affect you in a negative light, then you have to let go of them. 5. The victim. Victims have a habit of pitying themselves. Their mirror reflects a defenseless child that cannot fend for itself. Since other people do not usually show them sympathy or empathy, they try to give it to themselves in any way. To the victim, nothing ever done to them is right. Everything is wrong. The glass is always half empty and never half full. The conversation of the one who plays the victim is always filled with whining and complaints, blaming every other person but never themselves. Making excuses and not taking personal responsibility are the best indicators of a person being the victim. This person will never be able to apologize for anything because nothing seems to be their fault. They are mere victims. The victim uses her position to rally people around her to care for her and protect her. There are people out there who enjoy to play the role of the victim. They never take responsibility for themselves or their mistakes. Hurt feelings, guilt trips, perceived debt, all of these are tricks that victims keep close at hand. If you have a soft heart for wounded people, you probably attract a victim. If you have one of these people in your life, they will not miss any opportunity to make you feel like everything is your fault. Put a stop to it before they can start wrapping you in their blame game. Goodreads author Hans Hansen once said that people can inspire you or drain you. It will be best if now and then you stop to think and analyze the people in your life, whether they are more harmful than they are helpful.